The Go Higher podcast is provided by the High Program at Wayne State University. The High Program, helping individuals go higher.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Go Higher podcast, where we take on the tough and relevant subjects in everyone's day-to-day lives and provide insight on how to respond, resolve, and re-inspire yourself and those around you. Today's job market is a very different place than it was even a couple decades ago. Previously, it was almost guaranteed that if you graduated from college with some sort of degree, that you would end up with a well-paying job. However, now many experts suggest that a college degree is the new high school degree. For this reason, it is becoming very competitive for college students to get jobs. One way that you can give yourself an advantage is through effectively networking. Networking is a great way to make sure that you receive relevant advice regarding your career from industry professionals and made aware to positions that may not be widely advertised. That means it's time to get into the key word of the day, networking. The action or process of interacting with others to exchange information and develop professional or social contacts. This exchange of information is something that is very important to those who wish to succeed in any field. However, this skill is especially important in the business world, where it is very important that you get every reasonable advantage that you can. Due to the competitive nature of the business world, networking can literally make or break your career in some cases. For this reason, here are some tips that should help you network effectively. Come with a plan. You should be respectful of the person who you are asking advice from. For this reason, it is very important that you come with a solid plan of what you want that person to advise you on. No one likes their time being wasted, and networking should be treated the same way. Do come in with a plan of action. Do not come with no idea of what you want. Doing such makes you seem unfocused and uninterested. Use your resume. Your resume is a great tool for getting advice. In asking someone to review your resume, you are getting a pair of professional eyes upon them. This is very important, as industry professionals will be able to tell you if they have any recommendations on how to improve your resume. Your resume may also lead to an opportunity, as the reviewer may see your qualifications and interests as a perfect match for a certain company or job opening that they are aware of. Leverage social media. Due to the relatively recent advent of social media, networking has never been easier. An easy way to network is to connect with someone through social media and see if they have relevant experience toward your field of work. At first, commenting or liking their posts should be enough. However, you can soon leverage that into directly messaging them and hold a conversation with them. Do not ask for a job. Networking should never be used to ask for a job. It should be used to get advice on how to proceed in the job search or information that may assist with this search. The main goal of networking is to develop a relationship with someone. In doing this, that person will be more likely to recommend you for a potential job opening or an advancement opportunity in the future. Always follow up. It is very important that you follow up with someone after the meeting. It can be hard to get all your questions answered during a networking meeting, and following up is a great way to get the rest of these questions answered. It is best to contact someone 48 hours after you met them and thank them for their time and advice. In this email, make sure you ask them if they have the availability to meet again if you have questions in the future. Contact your alumni network. This is something that can be very helpful. Alumni events can be especially effective for networking since there is a common bonding factor. Going to the same university allows both of you to share common experiences, and alums from your school may be more willing to help than you could ever believe, and you should use that network to your advantage. Join hobby groups. These groups are especially important because they allow you to be among other people who have similar ideas and interests. In joining a hobby group, you'll be able to connect with other members in a very real way, and in a way that is genuine. It is very easy to find these groups. For example, poetry clubs in Detroit. These groups are another great way to network. Be strategically active on LinkedIn. Being active on LinkedIn is a great way to make sure that you remain on someone's radar. Try to share some relevant articles from colleagues once a week. This helps you stay more relevant in people's minds and remain on the top of the search bar. Overall, networking may seem like a lot, but it is something that is very important to your career and can help you find opportunities that you could never even dream of.
College can be difficult, but for some students, financial issues can make things impossible. The HI program at Wayne State University provides critical funds to students who are having major issues with basic needs like tuition, books, housing, and food. It's amazing, but just a few hundred dollars at the right time can save a student from dropping out or from being homeless. Students should not have to decide between basic life needs and finishing their education. The HI program has connected hundreds of students with these basic needs and provided a light at the end of the tunnel for what amounts to the most difficult period of their young lives. If you would like to help, donations of any amount are welcome, and you can find all our information on hiprogram.wayne.edu or at WSU High Program.